I'm in a laboratory that's part of the largest hospital in the world dedicated solely to research, the National Institutes of Health's Building 10. Imagine you're diagnosed with a life-altering condition, like cancer or diabetes or heart disease. Your doctor recommends a standard course of treatment, and you breathe a sigh of relief knowing medicine has something to offer. You are comforted knowing that so many others have already benefited from it. But where did that pill or therapy come from? For every treatment we rely on today, there was a moment when no one knew if it would work, and a first brave patient volunteered to try it. What's called a first-in-human trial. Now, for the very first time, the NIH has allowed cameras to follow these patients and doctors on their remarkable journey. I'm Jim Parsons, and this is First in Human.
When I signed up to do this job, I was aware of the fact that there's moments that are breaking.
There's got a lot of disease. Everyone who works here has a goal, trying to solve the unsolvable.
Do you think the dose is adequate to get you back under control?
Yeah.
To be able to take something from the lab and bring it to a patient and have it work, it's amazing.
If your condition has arrived at a point where we, in the entire world's medical knowledge, have no idea what to do, there is no proven therapy, we are the place that may be able to provide that.
Virtually every patient that we treat have been told by their home doctors, I'm sorry, there's nothing in modern medicine that can help you today. The NIH exists to create tomorrow's medicine.
One of the things that's pretty remarkable and unique about Building 10 is that anyone who's treated here is enrolled on a clinical trial.
You take that idea that has been developed based on experiments that were conducted in the laboratory or in animals and use that to design a treatment for humans.
First in human has a lot of sort of heavy-weighted connotation. It means we don't know what's going to happen. It's like entering a black box. We know how they work in a lab. We know how they work in a dish. We can identify everything that happens, but we don't know what other factors are in play in the human environment.
His blood pressure is better, but he hasn't quite improved as much as I would have expected.
And his temperature, I asked, just came back up today, right?
Dr. Terry Fry is an oncologist and researcher who is leading one of the more than 250 first-in-human trials at the National Institutes of Health's Building 10. His trial is designed for leukemia patients whose cancer has resisted all standard care.
For, you know, maybe a couple of decades, there's been tremendous progress in treatment of leukemia, but we have to always strive to do better.
Bo Cooper hopes to be the next patient in this first-in-human trial.
I have a good feeling about this, like everything's gonna be good.
Yeah, it's gonna work.
Bo is a 26-year-old firefighter, medic, and mixed martial artist who has been battling leukemia for much of his adult life.
Being young, it's hard to face death so many times. I'm 26 now, and this is my third relapse. And that's not a good thing.
I wish you excited. Of course I am. Why wouldn't I be?
I've known Bo for over 6 years. We got married this year, so we're pretty much newlyweds. He wasn't as sick, so we decided, hey, you know, life is short, let's just get married right away. Bo has a very big heart. He's very strong-spirited, I guess. He just gets through all the obstacles in life. He's a champ.
All the tests are done, so.
Yeah.
I'm just happy that you're here.
Happy to have a chance.
It's a test. I'm a test subject.
Clinical research can be dangerous. People do sometimes die in clinical trials, and people have to know that they're accepting a risk, why they're accepting it, that there may be benefits for them, or there may be benefits for others.
If we knew what the risks were, we wouldn't need the research. Part of the point of the research is we're not 100% sure how severe they are and how frequent they are.
There is no effective drug, there's no effective treatment out there that wasn't at some point tested in the context of a first-in-human trial. There had to be a first human to receive that treatment.
Dear Heavenly Father, we have a number of people in this class that are sick or that love those that are. And we ask that you watch over these people, watch over their families, and we ask these things in your name.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for our sister Anita. We pray that you will give the doctors the knowledge and the wisdom they need to treat her, that you will bring complete healing to her body and to her mind and to her heart and soul, Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Anita McAlister, a 42-year-old mother of three, has metastatic melanoma, an aggressive skin cancer that has overtaken her body.
In you go.
Few with this disease survive beyond 5 years.
7 years ago, I had noticed a small spot on my left temple. I made an appointment at the dermatologist. The week or two later was when I get the phone call. The phone call. It was, oh, I'm so sorry, but it turns out it is melanoma. It was paralyzing to hear those words. I'd go to bed for 2 weeks because I just couldn't function. I had a one-year-old. I was still nursing. What actually went through my brain was she was going to grow up never having known me.
For 7 years, Anita has undergone multiple treatments, but her cancer has returned and metastasized, spreading throughout her body.
Everything that they were throwing at it really wasn't doing much of anything.
There we go.
Got it.
Oh, sclerotic.
Nice. Thanks, lovey.
Like Bo Cooper, there is no standard treatment left for Anita. And so she, too, has enrolled in a trial which will use her own immune system to fight her cancer.
Can you guys make your own lunch?
Yeah.
Two of you?
I don't want you to leave.
No, I don't want to go either.
I won't have anyone to snuggle with in the morning.
We don't really snuggle on school mornings anyway, because it's just get up and go, 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 go. You're okay?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Not really.
Not really.
I mean, I'm gonna miss you.
Anita is spiritually driven, has her focus on her faith, and that leads to a search for hope. Having a clinical trial available offers hope.
Hi, girls. Come hug Mama. Okay, now we go. I love you. Be a good girl.
You got this, okay?
Yeah,
I hear you. There we go.
Try and stand up as tall as you can.
Since its creation by an act of Congress in 1947, Building 10 has been responsible for some of the most important and far-reaching medical breakthroughs in history.
The first successful chemotherapy for cancer was done in this building. The use of lithium for depression.
The
discovery of AZT for HIV.
The first gene therapy, the list goes on. And yes, it's the public dollar, but it's a public dollar well spent.
Ready?
All right,
let's go.
The first in-human trial Bo Cooper is about to begin is in its first phase, which means Dr. Fry is trying to determine toxicity and dosage. It is the most dangerous part of clinical research.
You're excited because you possibly have something that's going to make a meaningful difference in patients. And at the same time, you know, it's incredibly scary because you just don't know what's going to happen.